So we see that this passage tells us about the San Juan Kit Fox, and it informs us about how the range-wide population prior to 1930 was about 8,000 to 12,000, and then in 1975 it was about 7,000. However, their habitat was coming into dire straits because less than 5% of its original habitat actually remained. However, the good thing was that although no one paid attention to the urban kit foxes in Bakersfield until 1985, the kit foxes actually could live in urban life. And hence, while creating new houses and stuff, developers were actually creating kit fox habitats. And thus, kit foxes still exist. And they move every couple of weeks to a new den. And the author speculates that moving to a different den may be one of the reasons why they have persisted. The constant changing abodes provided new places to hide. Thus, we can say that this whole passage is pretty much just informative. And it tells us about how the human influence or the urban light influences the kit fox and the kit fox's habitat. Hence, we choose option B. Inform readers about the San Juan kit foxes and human influence on their habitat and population.